The objective is first how to be proactive and find out people and prevent people to develop serious problem. How these are a spectrum of illness. Coming back to the how the healthcare has changed in last couple of years. You know, previously people have used to think that a hospital is the only place to get healthcare. I mean, if you look at now, how many people are controlling their own health? So if I ask you, how many people are you wearing any health applications in their smartphone or like Fitbit or on all these trackers? How many are you wearing or using or Google Fit, Google Exercise, cycling? So look, lot of people are using these devices nowadays to control their health on their own. So we all want to be healthy. We want to be fit. So you want to look at how our health, our activities. So the change, there are a lot of change from the people go to the hospital when they have heart attack versus how can prevent it? How can you prevent eating a healthy diet, maintain healthy weight, be active in most days? And so the thing has changed from the developing addiction versus preventing people develop the addiction or develop the problem. So that is approach all of us should do in our practice. What is proactive? Now, self-recognition or helping somebody recognize. Look, your drink is fine, but something you should be a little concerned. We don't want people to develop addiction because addiction has a lot of neurocognitive psychiatric complication. You saw 3 cases today. Every case has own problem. I mean, look, a person of 76 get addiction, a cannabis alcohol person get addiction and come to hospital, and other person had been presented in the beginning. So also the professional believe that the person with alcohol problem cannot be helped unless he develops addiction. So a lot of us think that, let people develop addiction, then should come to us, then we should treat. And you know what happened at the end of the day. I mean, if you look at the best center in the world, addiction outcome is not more than 20%. All the treatment is given. Why we used to bring consistently here for last 10 years, we never refused admission, knowing that things are not helping. In fact, we still don't know. I mean, why he committed suicide? And wife called me and telling that I'm taking the persons. He told that he has the tongue is out and he's taking him to the hospital to prove, I mean, to find out that or not. But obviously, it is obvious. I have to find out. No depression, no psychosis. Fairly, for somebody to understand well, no problem. But then the outcome, if you look at addiction, is very poor. And we are gradually seeing every month you are getting information about our patients dying much earlier. Though at least who know, who don't know, then obviously you never know what is happening. But each patient you ask, somebody tells somebody committed suicide, somebody turned a liver failure. So you don't want our people to get addicted and get into this. That's a serious problem. Look at spectrum of alcohol. This is how it is. One is abstinent, those who don't drink at all. Second is risky or hazardous drinking. The last, which you don't want, is dependent, as you discussed. So the majority of people you get in the risky or hazardous drinking, where I think proactive healthcare helps rather than the waiting for them to come. They're never going to come to you. They're very unlikely to come to you for only alcohol. They might come to think for something else. I mean, look at the data. If you look at the data, I've just taken out the National Family Household Survey. As you know, Government of India does household surveys for different conditions, including how many TV you have, how many. This is a family survey. One part of the survey is actually talk about how many people are drinking. One question, if you look at survey, is on drinking in India. Again, this is not specific for alcohol. It is for how many, how much per capita income, how many TV you have, how many bikes you have. They come to house and take the surveys. That survey tells you in India, 2015-16, 30% of people are drinking alcohol or have taken alcohol in last 1 year. Now, I'm not telling they're drinking every day. At least they have taken alcohol last 1 year. If you look at the old data, which is specific to alcohol, 20% people are drinking alcohol. The next question, how many are actually disorder? Fortunately, only 5% or less than 5% fulfill the criteria for alcohol addiction. I mean, 30% drinking once a while last 1 year, only 5%. So addiction is very, in that way, not a huge number. Now, I got one study which rural area that did the study, published in BMJ, in Madhya Pradesh, that used audit scale and found that among the drinker who are drinking, 33 are hazardous drinker, 3% harmful and 5% dependent. So you have almost 36% who are drinking heavily, which if you don't do anything, they're likely to develop problem, maybe physical problem, maybe accident, maybe death, maybe dependence. So you don't know what is going to happen, but then this is the status available in the, you know, in the PubMed. And unfortunately, all of us 2.8 took any help. If you look at the data, that same data, if you take 100 people that have one drink at least in 1 year, last 1 year, taken once, 26-28% are hazardous, around 3 are thing and 5% dependence. Now patient family comes to us, the case we're discussing now are all dependents. So which is more biological, which is like a, you know, almost inbuilt to the thing, where the reversal is very less. Whereas you're talking of the condition, the border condition, that harmful hazardous use, where you can reverse the person back to the normal and healthy level of thinking. The question is, how can I know that my friend drinking in hazardous drinking or harmful drinking? So how we will to advise somebody, you know, came across, he has never told that he's drinking, but you probably know that he's drinking once a while, but you are concerned about the drinking. Now your job is to convince him, or, you know, at least tell him, or he should know what is drinking is something he should think. It's like this. I mean, how much steps you are walking per day. So unless you know how many steps you're walking per day, you may not take more steps to walk at all. So the health trackers tell you, look, I should work for 10,000 steps or 12,000 steps to keep my fit. That's why we use trackers. In that context, I thought audit is something we'll demonstrate. So it'll take 5 minutes more to demonstrate the audit and then I'll leave to you. So what I wanted to use, that you have audit score with you. Have you downloaded the audit software? So I will interview now Malikarjun regarding the audit questions. You will rate the questions and tell me the score. So Malikarjun, my name is Prabhat. What brings you to here?
Yeah, doctor, I have a problem in my workplace. So I came to the hospital.
Yes, so you have a problem in workplace. That's why you have to come to visit me. Now, while I'm reviewing your history, you know, what given to me is that I came to know that you have occasional alcohol drinking, you know. I understand that you are not drinking heavily, but it's very important for me to get information so that, you know, we can plan it, how to help you out.
Very rarely I will drink. I'm not an alcoholic.
I understand completely. Obviously, you drink rarely. You are not heavy drinker or not alcoholic. But I will take 2 to 3 minutes so that I can get a little better information, and I will share with you also. I'm asking question about last 1 year. Last 1 year, how often do you have a drink containing alcohol? Like beer or whiskey or brandy?
Usually I used to have 2 or 3 beer and 2 or 3 shots of spirit.
In a week or in a month?
In a week.
How often drinks containing alcohol do you have typical day when you're drinking? How many units you'll drink?
I don't know exactly the units, like maybe around...
You told 90, me 2 to 3 beer, yeah, and 2 to 3 shots, correct? Yeah. And you again told me that. And is it on Friday, Sunday, Saturdays or something like that?
Usually it will go on Saturdays and Sundays.
Any time in last year, have you taken more than 6 shots, 6 units?
Never.
Never. In last year, any time you thought that, you know, you started drinking and you're not able to stop drinking, just go on increasing.
Never.
This will never happen. Last 1 year, have an occasion where you could not do your work because you have drank heavily? For example, you have a heavy drink on Saturday, or Sundays and Monday you find it very difficult to go to office because of headache.
Very rarely.
Very rarely.
Very rare.
So I could less than a monthly?
Yes.
As a month, it's not very common.
Not very
common. Any time in the last 1 year, you have to get up and first you have to take a drink. Then your body becomes stabilized and you have to go to the office.
This also happens very rarely.
Very rarely.
Very rarely.
So I put less than a monthly?
Yeah, less than a monthly.
Less than a monthly. But it happened with you?
Yeah, once it's happened.
Anytime you felt guilt, you have a drink and feel, look, I shouldn't have drank so much. I mean, okay, I had a drink, but then if I start feeling that amount is too high, I should, next time should not have so much.
Never.
Anytime you have blackout, you don't remember at all what happened. Never. So basically it means you've never taken so many heavy that you will forget anything. So you remember everything. Okay. In last 1 year, for your drinking, anybody's get injured? Like example, you are drunk and or yourself, drunk and walking and your trip, you fell down. Or you are driving and suddenly you hit somebody. Self or others?
No, never
happens. Nobody has been injured by your drinking. Anytime your friend, your spouse, your doctor has been concerned, look, things are getting out of control, you should take help, or should cut down.
Sometimes it happens. My family members used to advise me to cut down.
Is your spouse has told that you should cut down, and
yeah.
Last 1 year? Thank you. Thanks very much. Let's look at the score and get back to you. Okay. What is the score? So let me see. So you got how much?
Nine.
So let me calculate here. Yeah, 9 to 10. I think you are fairly right. So 9 to 10 was the fair bit of score. Now what he scored is first one, yes, 2 to 3 times a week. Second one, three, again, second is one, yeah. One is a score. Third, 0. Fourth, 0. Fifth, 1. Sixth, 1. 7, 0. 8, 0. 9, 0. 10, actually, he scored very heavily. 10 item score is 4. So 9 and 10 is the most important point in the thing. So 9 and 10 score is 0, 2, 4. There's no 1, 3 in between. You must have seen. So I'll come back. So 10. So in 10 score, what do you think? What you should tell him? So this is a scale I have made. So I think two things helps in audit. One, it gives a framework. It also clears our mind. Now you know what to do next. So like, you know, Ratana Madam telling, it gives you, look, this guy is medium risk, do this. And it's very interesting, self-administered. You know, somebody can administer. And remember, these are the condition. I'm not talking addiction at all. I'm taking a young person, let's say young IT person who drinks at the evening. He doesn't drink any day, drinks at a Friday evening, but drinks heavily so that he falls or some injury happens. Sunday is all right. So this is a very useful way to convince. Often I ask the enter the patient and show to the patient directly. Look what is written there. He'll medium risk. Rather, I'm telling, look, you have a risk, you are addicted, other than all. Because the case I get here is addiction cases, so they don't believe why they're here. So in our setting, you will not get these cases, you get a whole end spectrum. But in the community, in the local setting, headache, sleeplessness, occasional drinking, you get definite cases. And it's very good to show them, look, you have medium risk, and you can, you know, work it out. So this is, this is how you actually tell. You can tell that now I'm going to ask you some questions about your alcohol beverages. You don't use drink, use beverages last year. Or you can tell as a part of health services, like all of assessment, you want to check your little more about alcohol. Because remember, people have not come for it to you alcohol only. They have come from gastritis, pain, or some other non-specific symptoms, or even no symptoms. Anywhere you can apply, workplace, counseling center, college, school. Ask question as it is. Don't mix the question, one, first, third, four. Don't. Just follow the pattern, how it is. Okay, and I think this something is going out from here. So, past three questions talks of hazardous use. That is frequency, typical quantity, and heavy drinking. Second three questions talks about dependence. So, 4-5 questions talks about, this talks about dependence. So, if somebody score high, his dependence in this thing we got 1, 2, 3 high score, whereas 4, 5, 6 score is not very high. So he unlikely dependent, but more likely hazardous. So you can see all item I've written here. 4 means impaired control, 5 means salience, and 6 morning drinking. Last 7, 8, 9, 10 question talks about harmful use, guilt, blackout, injury, and concern by the family. So each question has a meaning. And this is the essence of what it is WHO approved, used across country, across world, across language. So it's been tested very effectively. The last slide. Now this is a risk zone. What you'll do next? Now in this case, what you'll do? So this is a case of hazardous use. Correct? Zone 2. So you got score of 9 to 10, as everybody mentioned. Which hazard is huge. In this case, we have spoken about PREMS in the past. Brief intervention is the key. So we have to tell about the brief intervention. I think you have discussed before also PREMS feedback. Well, I'll skip this one. I think similar beginner, you can see a 24-year-old student. He came to emergency, found drunk. Not every day doesn't drink. But he's coming down. This is a very typical profile of a college student where he drinks once a while, but drinks heavily. And that case, we did the audit, got 26. You know, it's not, looks very, you know, innocuous, but when you get higher score. So audit is a first step. Remember, this also helps engage. See, when person has not come for alcohol primary, it's very difficult to engage with him. So this is a good score to engage with the people. Look, let's start this discussion. And then also helps us to tell what is appropriate. When the addiction is established, life is much easier. But when this is not there, this is a problem. brief intention, as you know, it's very low intensity but very impactful, and can take as less as 5 minutes to finish whole assessment and intervention. Okay, now you are busy, you don't have time, you are extremely busy. Now 3 questions you ask. Often we are busy in our life, so you know, micro audit, I take an audit C or mini audit or whatever. Again, there are validated questions. So 3 questions you ask. How often do you have a drink? How many drinks you take? How often do you have 6 or more? 1 drink means 1 unit, 30 ml. Now you get more than 4 score, again he needs the advice or any help. Again, I'm not telling about addiction, I'm telling about the any help, any small concern, look, things you need to improve, cut down, you are crossing a limit, you are, I'm not telling you addicted, but things may worse further. So audit C, which is a shorter version, again all are validated, tested and all. Take home message, you have opportunity always, early detection, a brief intervention. Audit is the first stage of engagement. It helps you to engage. Easy and culturally appropriate, irrespective of your culture, you can use it. The audit is available in Hindi also, in the website you can download, it's free. I think I'll stop here. Done.